गुड डे स्टूडेंट, आई एम डॉक्टर मोनिका छेत्रपाल। आई एम एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर ऑफ फिजिक्स इन गवर्नमेंट डूंगर कॉलेज बीकानेर। टुडे आई विल डिलीवर ए लेक्चर ऑन सुपर कंडक्टिविटी। सो लेट अस बिगन, व्हाट आर सुपर कंडक्टर? सुपर कंडक्टिविटी वॉज डिस्कवर्ड बाय के ओम्स। ही डिस्कवर्ड दैट व्हेन Mercury is cooled below liquid helium, its resistance suddenly disappears. Resistivity and conductivity are inversely proportional to each other. Resistivity disappears, that means conductivity becomes infinite. So, superconductors are new type of materials which have infinite conductivity. For this, K. Ohms got a Nobel Prize. The temperature at which material becomes superconductor is known as critical temperature and it is denoted by TC. I will show this you in a graph. This is the graph for mercury and this shows the variation of resistivity with temperature. At TC equal to 4 Kelvin, the resistivity drops to 0. Conductivity becomes infinite. That means material becomes superconductor. So below TC, the material will be superconductor and above TC, the material will behave as a normal material. The most important examples of superconductor are aluminium, niobium, magnesium. Apart from this single elements, there are many alloys which can become superconductors. Earlier, some 24 elements becomes superconductor. But with the discovery of new structures, many new materials are continuously becoming available which can be superconductors. Now moving over to the next topic, empirical criteria for superconductivity. Are all materials superconductors? That means can we cool them so that they become superconductors? Below a low temperature, are they superconductors? No, this is not the case. All materials cannot be superconductors. There are some basic criteria that which material will be superconductor. First criteria is that superconductors are those materials for which the number of valence electrons lie between 2 and 8. The next criteria, which is shown by a graph, this shows the variation of TC and Z. TC is the critical temperature. As I have already told, TC means the critical temperature below which the material is superconductor and above which the material behaves as a normal material. The graph shows that there is a sharp maxima when number of valence electron Z is odd, that is Z equal to 3, 5, 7. And for even numbers, this graph shows a dip for Z equal to 2, 4, 6. Next criteria is that when elements in a periodic table, for them TC is determined and their Z square is determined and a graph is plotted between TC and Z square, we get a straight line. This shows that TC is directly proportional to Z square. This is the graph which is plotted between transition metals. Next criteria are for a single element, for example, for tungsten. Is tungsten available in all forms a superconductor? It has been found that beta tungsten can form a superconductor. Similarly, alpha manganese is a material which is conductive to the phenomena of superconductor. So all materials, they cannot be superconductor. It also depends upon their crystal structure. The next criteria which defines the superconductivity is that superconductivity occurs only for those materials which have high normal resistivity. The condition n rho greater than 10 to the power 6 is a good criteria for the existence of superconductivity. Here n means the number of valence electrons per centimeter cube. and rho is the resistivity in electrostatic unit at 20 degree Celsius. It has been found for a superconductor, the conductivity cannot be infinite for a long time. When current through a superconductor is increased beyond a critical value, the superconductor again becomes a normal conductor. Ferromagnetic and anti-ferromagnetic materials are not superconductor. This is the most important criteria for the existence of superconductivity. Monovalent metals, they are generally not superconductor. The most interesting point is that gold, silver, which at normal temperatures are good conductors, but they are not superconductors. So this myth that good conductors can be superconductors, it's a simply a myth. These criteria define which material will be conductor and which material will not be superconductor. Thank you.